Hello, and welcome to Skills to Pay the Bills and today's segment featuring the Lincoln Heritage Insurance Company. Please welcome my co-host, Mr. Gary Trice. Hello, Gary. How
Hello.
Are you?
Fine, Tia. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Gary Great. Is a regular. He's been on as our subject matter expert. And, you know, he's having a little bit of laryngitis today, so we'll try not to work him too hard. Our special guest today is Miss Angela Waul, Managing General Agent for Lincoln Heritage. Angela, hello. How are you?
I'm doing great, Tia. Thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for taking away the time from your busy schedule, because I know how busy you are. So we really appreciate your being here.
Thank you.
So we're going to get right into our discussion today. Angela, tell us, who is Lincoln Heritage?
Lincoln Heritage Life Insurance Company is an insurance company that has been around ever since 1963. In fact, this year we will be celebrating our 50th year anniversary in the Dominican Republic.
Whoa.
In February, on February 7th, as a matter of fact.
That's great. Will you be there?
I will be there.
Oh, wow, that's great. Take me with you. Angela, give us a summary of the type of products that Lincoln Heritage offers its clients.
Lincoln Heritage primarily offer the clients whole life insurance for burial coverages. Mm-hmm. And, you know, that's really the main focus, is for your final expenses and your burial coverage.
For burial coverage, mm-hmm. Okay. Is this just here in the United States, or is this a worldwide organization?
Lincoln Heritage is available in 48 states in the United States. Okay. So as of right now, we are just here.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what happens if a person is from another country, they're living here, maybe they've been here in America for 20 or 30 years, and they have a policy and they decide that they want to, you know, go back home to someplace, is that policy still valid?
The policy is still valid.
Wow,
as long
great.
As the client continues to make their monthly payment, their premium payment, the policy is still valid, and wherever they are, the payment would be sent to them at that particular location upon their death.
Right. Well, I know that, as I said earlier, Gary is a subject matter expert. He's works with several of the large brokering firms and has a lot of clients. Gary, have you ever had an opportunity to use the product?
Yes, I have, and I think it's a great product too, but I would like to have Ms. Angela Waul kind of explain to us what's the separator from Lincoln from all the other companies that offer final expenses.
One of the main things that separate us is one of the programs that we have, which is called the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society, and they work exclusively with Lincoln Heritage. And what it does is allow our clients to be able to pretty much map out everything that they want for their funeral services, mm-hmm. You know, their final wishes. And they will help the family, you know, negotiate prices. It's a wonderful tool to have, so that, because, you know, think about it, if something was to happen to you, who would be the person in charge of your funeral arrangements? And do they know what you want? You know, down to the simple things, like what is it that you'd like to wear? So that's one of the reasons why we are set apart from a lot of the other traditional insurance companies. And another thing is, upon receipt of a death claim, Lincoln Heritage will issue the money to the funeral homes or the beneficiary within 24 to 48 hours. Therefore, the family doesn't have to, you know, collect money or take out loans or anything like that.
Wow.
For burial expenses.
Right. Angela, what would you say, you know, just based on what you just finished sharing with us, what would you say to those viewers who would say, well, you know, I've got all kinds of insurance, why do I really need a final expenses policy? Because I've got other insurances mm-hmm. To take out. What would you say to those people?
I would say that that's great, because, you know, most of the people that I sit down with already have traditional coverage, some other type of coverage, I should say. And the reason that they took that out is for other reasons, like to replace income, mm-hmm. if something was to happen, to pay off the home, for the kids to go to college. And, you know, a lot of people are not really thinking about their actual burial expenses when they take that out.
That's
so
true.
That money is earmarked for those particular reasons, and final expense is earmarked just for that reason, which, of course, allows you to put your plans in place.
Wow. It must be really expensive to add the financial guardian group to the policy. Is that very costly?
Not at all. In fact, with the Lincoln Heritage Final Expense Plan, the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society is absolutely free.
You don't pay anything?
Nothing.
Is that an exclusive?
That's exclusive to Lincoln Heritage only.
So that means that there's no other company in the nation, I guess, that is offering that kind of benefit.
There is not.
Wow.
That's almost too good to be true. Angela, let's see. I gotta give a real live estimate here. What? Let's say that, and this did happen earlier this year. My brother passed, and let's say I had a Lincoln Heritage policy. Walk me through what would happen.
Okay.
Let's say I'm the beneficiary.
Okay.
Right.
Let's just go back to maybe say the beginning. Okay. Initially, when I come out and sit down with your brother, I would explain the whole program to him and let him know how he can put his plans in place and where the plans would be available for his beneficiary. So once he gets his policy in the mail, they will give him forms to complete that is going to outline everything that he wants. Okay, he sends them back to the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society. They put them in a secured computer archive system. So once he has done that, he'll receive membership cards. And since you're the beneficiary, I would also sit down with you and explain the membership card and what it is that you would have to do upon his death. And basically, all you have to do is call that 800 number. You call the 800 number to the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society, they will pull his records. And whatever funeral home that he has selected, they will contact them. And they will also contact some of the other funeral homes in the area just to kind of get a price comparison so that we make sure that your brother would get the services that he wanted and they are within the price range that he had already estimated for his funeral.
So does the price range go up? Let's say that he got this policy 10 years ago at X number of dollars, mm-hmm. and it's 10 years later. So am I, as a beneficiary, going to have to haggle back and forth about the cost of the coffin?
You will not. That's what the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society will do.
So they take out all that in-between stuff that you have to do.
Yes, they do, and
wow,
they do research. They do all of your footwork. So, you know, you wouldn't have to be looking here and there for cost of vaults and caskets and things like that, because they will do all of that research for you, make sure that you get what you want within the price range that you have already selected.
That's very comforting to know, because, you know, just from personal experience, that was a very trying time for me and my family, just having to go through looking at all the books and trying to figure out what my brother would want. And I mean, it was just not a pleasant time at all. And even though the funeral organization that was in charge, they were very customer friendly and really nice, but it was just something missing. And it sounds like you have the missing link. Gary, what do you say about this?
Along that planning process, say we decided what we wanted, and maybe a year later, I decided I want to change my mind. Can we do that? And how does that change take place?
Okay. So if you decided that you wanted to make a change, when I spoke earlier, I talked about the membership cards. So you would have a membership card with the 800 number on it and a number that that is exclusive for you. You call the 800 number, let the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society know of any changes that you would like to make. They will make those changes for you, and it's not a problem at all.
Wow.
You know, even if you decided that first you wanted to be cremated, but now you want to have a traditional burial, then they would just make those changes for you and get the pertinent information that would be needed.
Wow. So let me ask you this question. You said that this is an exclusive to Lincoln Heritage. How much research has gone into what the Funeral Consumer Guardian are doing?
The The research that has gone into it, the owner of the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society actually was a funeral director, okay? Mm-hmm. So he does, all he does is research to make sure that the prices that we put out are comparable in different states, in different areas. So he does extensive research, and that's what they do all the time.
Wow, and why is that so important that they spent so much money into research? Why is that so important? How does that help the client?
It helps the client because you could go to ABC Funeral Home and they could charge one thing, or you could go to John Smith Funeral Home right across the street and they might charge another, or right down the road and they might charge another. So what the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society will do is they will call each of the funeral homes, and it's common knowledge. Every funeral home has to have a consumer price list, which is available. I mean, you could walk into any funeral home and get it, really, but they will compare those prices with each of the funeral homes, and you know, they will negotiate with the funeral homes to make sure that, you know, everything stays within the budget of what the client has already specified.
Fantastic.
Wow, that's great. We're going to pause for a short station break, but before we do, we want to let you know how you can contact us by email skillstorock@gmail.com, or you may call us at 703-468-0834. Don't touch that dial. We'll be right back.
Whether you want to create a show of your own or just learn about radio and television, Fairfax Public Access offers training programs that are perfect for you. Studio classes put you on the set, and field classes take you on location. Learn how to put footage together in our editing suites. If it's music or talk you're into, we offer courses in radio production. Best of all, air your program on one of our cable channels. Give us a call or visit our website at fcac.org.
Welcome back. You're watching Skills to Pay the Bills, and today's special guest is Ms. Angela Waul of Lincoln Heritage Insurance Company. We also have my very good friend and co-host, Mr. Gary Trice.
Thank you.
Welcome back, folks.
Good to be back.
Angela, one of the things that impressed me before the break is with the Consumer Guardian organization. They appear to be really big into customer service. Can you talk about that? Am I correct in feeling that way?
Yes, you are. And what I'll share with you is a personal story. This doesn't happen often, but the policy happened to be on my aunt. And so instead of calling the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society at 2 o'clock in the morning, they called me because it was my aunt that passed away. So I got on the phone at 2 a.m. with the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society. And at that time, they contacted funeral homes, they got us prices, they did everything that they said that they would do. And we were very, very pleased with how they helped us through that you know, very trying time.
Right, and that is a trying time. Mm-hmm. I know that, you know, for people that are pretty healthy, you can always find something for them. But in the case of my brother, he had prostate cancer. And at the time, I didn't know about Lincoln Heritage, and he didn't have any coverage. And someone told me about another organization, a competitor of yours, and I had signed up with them, and you know, thank God we were able to have some benefit for him. Do you offer benefits for those people that are less than healthy?
Yes. With our policies, there are two uninsurable questions. So the first one would be if a person was HIV positive or they had active AIDS. The second is if someone is incarcerated in a care facility, in a hospital, or, you know, bedridden. Those are the only people that would not be covered. So it's if a person has cancer, is on dialysis, has had a stroke, everybody can be covered other than the two questions that I spoke about earlier.
Okay, and then are these people, do they have the same rates as everybody else, or their rates are a little different if they are less than healthy?
Right. If a person is less than healthy, and you know, this has occurred within the last 2 years, the benefit would be what we call the modified benefit. It does cost a little more, but you know, they still have a benefit. So what happens is in the first year, the client would, if they passed away, the family would receive back the premiums that were paid plus an additional 10%. In the second year, they would receive all of the premiums, and an additional 20%. So when with clients, you know, say to me, well, maybe it is a little expensive, I would say, well, you know, even if you save the money and put it in the bank, are you really going to get 10% on it,
right,
or 20%?
Yeah. And I'll tell you, when you are trying to stand with a loved one who has a dread disease like that, you're just very grateful, and it's worth the extra money that you have to pay, because my family would have been devastated without that coverage. Mm-hmm. And I'm really happy to hear and know about what you're saying. Gary, what has been your experience? Have you had clients that you've been able to talk to them about Lincoln Heritage?
Oh, yes. And all of my clients so far have been approved, even with modifications.
Really?
Yeah, so far no one has been turned down. I am truly, truly grateful that I am able to offer service where that the majority of the people can qualify for the service. But I do have a couple questions I would like to ask Ms. Waul.
Sure.
And one is, what if I wanted to insure my entire family? Could I have the whole family, myself, my wife, and two kids all on the same policy? How would that work?
With adults over the age of 18, they would get their own policy, okay? So you would get your policy, your wife would get her policy. Any children under the age of 18 can become riders on your Lincoln Heritage policy at a minimal fee.
And what is their coverage level? How much coverage can I have for those kids under 18?
The coverage for the children can go up to $25,000 per child.
Mm-hmm. And is there an age limit that disqualifies one?
The age limit is 85. As long as you get in to the plan before your 86th birthday, then you're covered for life.
Wow, so you pretty much covered a whole gamut, a whole spectrum.
Yes, 0 to 85.
So let me ask you this, is that one of the reasons why Lincoln Heritage rate like number one in the final expense business?
That is one of the reasons why we rate number one, because there are so, you know, there are other entities that, you know, cut off very early, mm-hmm, or the plan is only going to last until they're 75 or 85. So, mm-hmm, you know, with ours, even if you came in at 85, it's going to last for life.
Okay. And when you say last for life, so if I came in at 65 and now I'm 85, do I still get the complete coverage, or is it decreasing?
It does.
As
it never decreases.
Never decreases.
Your payments, your premium payments would never increase, and your policy amount would never decrease.
Oh, so
as long as you make your monthly payment, of course.
Wow, well, let me ask this one quick question before I turn it back over to Ms. Young. Say, for instance, I had a loved one and the loved one passed on, and the beneficiary, does the check go to the beneficiary or does it go to the funeral home? Where does the check go? And if there's a difference in the cost and the residuals left over, what happens with those?
Okay. What happens is the check is going to go to the funeral home, okay, to cover the final expense, the final expenses of which it was taken out for in the first place. So let's say you had a $25,000 policy and your loved one funeral cost $10,000. Once the funeral home has been satisfied, the other $15,000 will come to you, the beneficiary, in a check.
Well, let me ask you this question then, because that brings up another question for me. So I'm going to send, Lincoln is going to have a $25,000 check go to the funeral home. What if I want to request that to go straight to the beneficiary? Because if it goes to the funeral home and the funeral home decides I'm going to have this funeral and it's going to cost $25,000, where it should have cost $10,000, how do you offset that?
It's offset by the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society, because they're going to know up front what the charges are for that particular for funeral service, okay? So what they could do as well is just go ahead and pay the funeral home the $10,000, send you the difference.
And they can do that up front?
They can do that up front.
Wow.
Because they already know what the prices are, because they have already negotiated with the funeral home and the family, you know, with the family there to get that particular fee.
Good. Sounds like full service.
It does. Full service. Angela, as you and Gary were talking, I was thinking about, do you know off the top of your head, and you don't have to be exact on this, what is the average cost of a funeral here in the Washington metropolitan area?
In the Washington metropolitan area, let's say we kind of put our funeral services in three different categories, a good, a better, and a best. Mm-hmm. So a good quality funeral, which is kind of basic, would be around $7,000. Now that does not include the cemetery plot or the opening and closing of the grave.
So that's at least another, what, $4,000 or $5,000, maybe more?
I would estimate it to be another $3,000, $3,500, you know, depending upon the cemetery that you went to.
So you're talking probably $10,000.
Yes.
$10,000 to $12,000.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And what does that include? We know that it doesn't include the burial plot, but does it include flowers and what does it include?
It includes your casket, mm-hmm. The outer container that, you know, a vault or a concrete liner, whichever you choose. It would include the flowers, the transportation, all of the services at the funeral home, whatever they charge for dressing, cosmetizing, embalming, all of that is
wow.
already covered in there. And the good thing about it is even your clergy stipend is included in
wow.
there. Your
oh,
printing
I have a
package.
Question. I bet I got you on this one. I have a question. What if I pass here in this area, but let's say my home is in Tennessee, in Memphis, Tennessee. Am I gonna have to pay extra money? Or my beneficiary, are they gonna have to pay extra money to ship me back to Tennessee?
That's one of the questions that I ask clients when I sit down with them. Mm-hmm. You know, if someone is here in the Washington, D.C. area, and if they live in Tennessee, Georgia, or where, if they want to be buried there. So what I would do at that time is to make sure we have enough money in there to be able to get your body back to its proper place. Right. And the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society is going to help you along the way with getting the airline tickets, to making those arrangements. It's going to take so much off of the family. That's
wow,
why,
that's great.
You know, we have so many people that love the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society and Lincoln Heritage Life Insurance Company, because it takes so much of the pressure off of
that.
The family, and gives the client a peace of mind in knowing that their family doesn't have to deal with all of that.
Well, is there an opportunity, because I know that some just basic insurance companies will offer an opportunity to add accidental death on there and disembodiment. Does Lincoln Heritage do that?
Yes, it does. Very
oh, wow.
minimal cost. You can get accidental death and dismemberment. Accidental death, whether you died as a result of any particular accident, a car accident, you know, whether you lost one hand, one arm, you would receive benefits for that. If it was an act of war, terrorism, and one of the nice things about
That's
it
awesome.
Is if you're That's on really vacation, something. And you have the accidental death and dismemberment mm-hmm. Attached to your policy, then if you were on vacation and you were more than 500 miles from home, it's already built in to that accidental death and dismemberment policy to have you shipped back for no extra fees.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Wow.
Gary?
Wow, so are those benefits separate from the funeral benefits, or accidental death and the funeral? Is that the same, or is it separate? Where do the check go? Does a check come here for the funeral services? Does a check go there for the accidental death? How does that work?
The accidental death, it would work pretty much the same. If it was an accidental death, then let's say you had two units. Your family would receive an additional, say, $20,000 on top of whatever the face amount is, okay? So the accidental death and dismemberment portion of it would go to the beneficiary, and then the rest of it would be used for the funeral services and whatever has been determined by the Funeral Consumer Guardian Society and the funeral home will go to the funeral home, and the rest goes to the beneficiary.
Wow,
that is really something. Angela, we're just about out of time, but I want you to share with the viewers how people can get in contact with you.
I can be reached at 443-532-4740. And my email is awaul2010@gmail.com. Again, my phone number is 443-532-4740.
Thank you. We are just about out of time, but I want to take this opportunity to thank you so much. It's just been a pleasure to have you here. You've shared with us a lot of information, and the discussion I feel has been enlightening as we talk about final expenses through Lincoln Heritage. We would love to have you come back, Angela, because I have at least 10 questions that I didn't get to ask you. Would you come back?
I would love to come back.
Well, we thank you so much, and would like to, you know, if I had anything that I could leave the viewers with, I would say that you need to go and pull out every insurance policy, health policy, annuity, and any other important document that affects the protection of you and your family. You need to make sure you understand what you have. If you don't understand it, call up your agent. If you cannot get in touch with your agent, call me, and I will put you in contact with someone who can provide you with the information and education that you need concerning the protection of your most valuable asset, your family. Call me at 703-468-0834 or any of the folks that you've heard from today. And don't forget, this is real important. Skills to Pay the Bills is on weekly this year, on Wednesdays at 1:30 a.m. and on Thursdays at 7:30 p.m. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.